series in Jesus' name. When you are in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1 to 6, as they are usual, say amen, so we all see what we read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Verse 1 say, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it, meaning by faith, the elders obtain a good report. Other versions say they obtain a good testimony. For by faith we understand that the world were framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of the things which are visible. Verse 4 says, by faith Abel offered to God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, through which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gift. I want God also to testify of my gift in this time, in Jesus' name. Amen. And through it, he being dead, still speaks. Verse 5 says, by faith, Enoch was taken away so that he did not see death, and was not found because God had taken him. For before he was taken, he had this testimony that he pleased God. And what causes him to please God? Verse 6 says, but without faith, it is impossible to please him. In other words, it is impossible. It cannot be done. It is impossible to please God when faith is not there. For he who comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. Now in that verse 6, is giving us the characteristics of every person. When they are coming to God, two characteristics must be there. Number one, they must believe that God is. By God is, it means the existence of God. You have to, that should not be questioned, that is there God or no God. The existence of God cannot be questioned. So one must believe that God is. Are we together? And by God, we mean all that God is, the attribute of God, the being of God, the power of God, the nature of God. Everything that makes God to be God cannot be questioned but believed when we are approaching God. Number two, God has every intention to respond to the person who's approaching God by faith. Are we together? That's why he said, but without faith, it is impossible to please God. For he who comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. We are living in the times, as we put out even the message the other day, we are living in the times that almost in all types of relationship, the issue of trust is a problem. Be it when in a marriage relationship, you will see people are living together, but somehow there is a part where this one doesn't trust the other one on. Are we together? And when you go to work, you find the employer-employee relationship, you will see the boss does not trust you in a particular thing. And you as well, you know, I don't trust my boss when it comes to this matter. In every type of relationship, even in business, when you are dealing with people, somehow you see you trust them in this, but in this one, you don't trust them. Now, when you are living in this environment where the issue of trust is affected in every type of relationship, it has as well the potential of affecting your walk with God, because also we need to trust God. Are we together? The people you see we relate with, there is an issue of trust. Now when it comes to God, how do I trust God when I don't trust any other person all the time? But God, I need to trust him all the time, so that my walk with him is an effective walk here on earth. Are we together? So now the very first verse we read, let's break it down. Hebrews 11 verse 1, it says, now faith is. Now this verse, the reason we are choosing it, because it defines us nicely what faith is. It says, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Faith is, now faith is. In other words, faith is in the present. Faith was not, faith will not, faith is. Every time we are relating with God, faith is in the present. It's not that I will trust God next year, but now I'm not going to trust Him. Faith is. Tomorrow, today, faith is. When I get to tomorrow, faith is. When I get to 2020, faith is. So faith is in the present. Faith is in the present. Relating to that. So through, now when we talk about faith is in the present, in this scripture that is described,